Whether you're coaching, teaching, or providing some other online service, one of the first questions we need to ask ourselves is, how are we going to get paid? If that's you, you're in the right place. Go ahead, get a pencil and paper, get ready to take some screenshots, or just save this video for later. Let's get started. Let's take a look at a few different ways to get paid using Stripe, as well as some ways to avoid the fees that can get piled on each payment that you receive. Let's get going. So first off, you're going to need an account. So head on over to Stripe.com, get your account set up. Now, you're likely going to need to be Stripe verified to do this. And I am not going to go into that in this video. Depending on when you're watching this, things could have changed. So I'm not going to put that information out here, but make sure you follow those instructions. For me, it required me to have either a website or a Facebook business page to show that I was legitimately a business and not trying to scam people. So just do what you need to do to show that you're legit and get started. Once you are verified, you're set to go and we can get rolling on the next step. So the next step is creating invoices. For me as an online teacher, this looks like creating invoices for packages of classes with my students. For example, a package of 10 classes per class, what's the cost? Who's taking on the fee? That sort of thing. So there are two ways to do this. One would be an invoice sent via email, and one would be a payment link. Let's go take a look at what these two options look like and which one might be better for you. So here we are on my Stripe dashboard. Just excuse all the blurring that's going to have to happen in this video due to private information, but we want to get to our payments. So let's head up here. We're at home. We want to head to payments. And then we're going to head to create payment. Over here, we're going to have a little drop-down menu that has invoice, payment link, subscription, manual payment. I stick to the top two, invoice and payment link. When we head to invoice, we're going to get a little notice here at the top. Pricing changes for invoicing starting November 1st, 2023. Depending on when you're watching this, this is going to be really important to pay attention to. And that's why we're going to look at option number two in just a second. Invoicing via email is fantastic. It's very easy, very simple for the person on the other end who's going to pay this. But here's the idea. You add your customer. For me, I keep all my students and their families with their parents' email address right here. But you could easily add a new customer. I might add my name. Melissa is teaching. Then I'm going to choose the item. For example, if I've got a new product, I could add that there. For me, these are packages of classes. So basically it goes along with the price that you're charging and the amount of classes being charged. So if I've got 10 classes and each class is $30, so I might say for Melissa, if we're going to go with my example, 30 times 10 classes plus fee. They are taking on the fee for our classes. There we go. We've got one chunk of these classes, and that's $300 plus the fee for these classes. So these classes, in this example, $30 times 10 classes, $300 plus the WeChat Pay fee. This is where it really pays to take a second, evaluate where your student or family is from, and then where they're paying to. Make sure you know what the fees are. If you're in Europe, for example, the WeChat Pay fee, I believe, is only 1.3%. In the United States, it's 2.9% plus 30 cents per transaction. Go figure. So I know that I need to factor that in. For larger packages of classes, if a family is going to pay for 20 classes at a time, I'll usually take on the fee. That's fine with me. I would rather have that type of longevity versus a short-term, kind of short-term package type thing. In this case, let's say that the family is going to take on the fee. I do 300 times 0.29. That is the 2.9%. And that gives me $8.70. So what's our grand total, boys and girls? $308.70. Perfect. So $308 is what I'm going to invoice. Therefore, when it comes into my Stripe account, that $8.70 is going to fly off into Stripe land, and I'm going to hopefully come out with the $300 that I'm expecting, minus 30 cents probably. So there we go. I'm going to go ahead and save that. There you go. That item is in there. And then I'm going to request payment. When I do this, I can choose a custom date, maybe today or something. So maybe I'll give them a week. About a week. until October 31st to do this. And then I want to take away the other options. If they use a transfer or a card or a cash app, it's going to be a different fee and things are going to get thrown off a little bit. So I'm only giving them WeChat Pay as the option, but if your clients are in another part of the world and another option is better for them, leave it there or take away the options according to what they're going to need. Then I'm going to email the invoice to the customer, include a link to the online payment page. For WeChat Pay, for example, they'll have a QR code. One of the things I run into sometimes is they'll say, it's not working. My payment is getting rejected. A lot of times they'll be used to scanning straight on their phone where they're reading the actual message, where they're reading the email. So what I have found to work is that they need to read the email on one screen and scan using a second device. That usually resolves it. It's always resolved it. So something to keep in mind. Then we've got a memo. I usually add in the dates for our classes. This package begins on this date. That's just for my own records as well as them, just so that we don't have any confusion. We can go back and check in case the amount of classes has kind of gotten out of whack. Then we're going to review invoice. Then we can preview our invoice over here. So it's got some of my information. It's going to have the payment information. And then I can just click review invoice and send that invoice and it will arrive at their email. Okay, that was payment with an invoice. Let's go ahead and create payment link. This is where we're going to avoid those new fees that are coming in. With a payment link, we're going to do the same idea as what we did with the invoice. However, we're going to just send a link and I can reuse this link and I'm going to have to create my own email. That's basically the difference. So here are the products. I can choose a subscription or I'll just stick with what I usually do, which is over here. Again, let's use my example, Melissa. 10 classes at $30 plus fee. Then I will write down here, 300 plus, $8.70 for the fee. And then anything else, any other notes, like when our class is starting, I can upload a photo here so that my invoice looks a little bit more professional. If you'd like, get my logo in there. The price, here we go, $308.70. It's in US dollars. This is a one-time thing. And one other difference here is that there is no way to take away certain payment options. So that card option, the other apps, I need to do my part to say, hello, family, this is your payment and this price is specific to using WeChat Pay. If you are considering using a different form of payment, please let me know and I will recalculate the cost. That way there's no confusion later on and we're going to get exactly what we're expecting. Once I've added this product, I can click add product and I will create a link and I will come up with a link. Here's the link, copy this link, and I'll go put it in an email where I'll send it to the family. When I send it to the family, I always add in, again, just that explanation of the math, where did I get this number from, and when our class date is starting, when I expect their payment by, and then boom, shakalaka, usually I get that confirmation within a day or two, and they're off. So again, you can easily use that payment link for the next package of 10 classes. Send another email, say, hey, it's time for our next package, and you're set. I do want to mention one more thing that sometimes families will request a receipt. If you're using the payment link, they will not get an automatic receipt. Therefore, if they need it for tax purposes or something else, that is really important to be able to do for them. It's a service that we should provide. That's a very professional thing to do. And there's a way to do it. Let me show you. After you've had a successful payment go through, you have some options. Look down here where the three dots are on the right. So this family paid $325. I can go over here, click on the three dots and click send receipt. If I click that, I've got the person's email address that will come up and I send that right on over. It's really that easy and it arrived instantaneously. I confirmed with the family soon after I did it and they said, yep, all set. Thank you very much. So again, another way to use Stripe to invoice and send receipts successfully to your students or clients. So do you use Stripe and do you use it in this way? Or is there something I'm missing? I would love to know if you've got any Stripe insider secrets. I've been using Stripe for a little over 2 years now, and it's been a fantastic way to receive payment from other parts of the world. Obviously, there are other options like PayPal and Wise and Payoneer and direct bank transfers that you can look into. But if you're trying to lower those fees and reach different parts of the world that may be more difficult with those payment options, then this is a great thing to consider. Let me know if you got any questions below. And if nobody's told you yet today, thanks for doing what you're doing. It's important. Happy teaching.